Now moving on to cross country, I had the opportunity today to go over to Hewitt Trustful and meet with members of their cross country team and learn what they did during the pandemic. While the rest of the world was in quarantine last summer, the cross country team from Hewitt Trustful High School didn't sit around and do nothing. They decided to get out and help people in their community that couldn't help themselves. Matt Ankoviak got his teammates together and started Free Lawn Care, a company that offers free services to the elderly and disabled in the Trustful area.
Well, in the summers previous, we had all of us had done some kind of yard work to just make a little extra money on the side, and I think in that endeavor we realized that there are some people that just can't afford to have a regular service all the time, or if they have the money, there's just small things that they wouldn't really know who to call, like just to move boxes around or something like that, just so you couldn't get a real company out there for, and they just needed some help with that. But I think it all started when our coach has always instilled in us the value of community service. Like, he spends all of his weekends down at the food shelter in Birmingham serving. And I think just him instilling that value in us and even inviting a few of us to come down and help has just always really motivated us to want to do more for our community and the people around us.
We, as a group, collectively brought stuff that we had at our house, and then we had some people that said they had leftover equipment that they let us use and ultimately have. And we would just kind of pander for our family members. I got a lawnmower from my granddad that may or may not work. We got nicer lawnmowers just from doing jobs and getting donations and just stuff like that.
Well, our goal was really to just, obviously it was not the best kind of environment when we had started this with our global pandemic and such division in our communities. Our goal was really just to bring a little bit of good to the world and just help as many people as we could. If anybody else would like to add anything.
We got out of the house, that was nice.
did keep us active all summer.
It was definitely a long break, so we had to get something to do.
Yeah, if we're gonna get out of the house, you might as well be doing good. So
some of us got taken off from our jobs. Like, I know Matt, he was working somewhere, and I spent most of the time with him over the summer. I spent more time with him than, especially all of them, too.
We don't know how good we have it compared to most people, and we take a lot of things for granted.
Yeah, like you said, it really puts your own personal issues and problems into perspective when you just lend a hand to someone else who has it way worse than you.
The guys shared with us several of their favorite experiences and stories. It wasn't all work. They had a lot of fun, too.
We had Paul here, not really doing anything, so we're like, Paul, how about we get you, not like because he doesn't do anything, but like
doing stuff.
Yes, no. So we moved him over, and we're like, hey, you can go trim the hedges, and the hedge trimmers with the cord, like your only job is to not cut the cord. Well, about 10 minutes later, Paul's like,
And Matt bet Will and Sawyer it was lunch.
Oh, I forgot about lunch.
Free lunch. They would swim to the other side of the lake and back. And so they got all the way down there and they couldn't swim back, so they had to walk all the way around the property again.
It was a 20-minute swim to the other side.
And when they got back, Matt didn't give him lunch because they didn't swim all the way back.
Yeah, they didn't swim back. That's a bet.
And Will was cutting the bamboo with a machete. And he wasn't really paying attention. And so Will goes and he's talking to Dobbs and he just nicks his thumb a little bit.
Oh, my pointer finger.
Pointer finger.
That's right there too.
Hit him right on the knuckle.
Stitches. We had to take, who was it?
Ken.
Kent and Will. And they went to the ER that day.
I think it was more that injury wasn't that funny. The fact that our coach was there and he is very old school.
He was telling
comical.
Will that he was fine.
He's like, you're fine.
I knew I was fine. I just, when I hit my hand, I just looked at it. I was like,
We left some blood on her road that day.
And we didn't have any like medical. Well, after this incident, we had always had a first aid kit. But we had a old Santa hat in Kent's car that I used to put pressure on the wound.
I think it's brought us more community as a team, and just with like all of Trustful in general, because it really, I think, inspired others to do the same, and it also just really brought our team together because we'd get up every morning at about 7 and run 5 to 6 miles and then go and do lawn care for 4 hours. I think it all just brought us together.
So usually what we're going to do is we're going to pass it on to the senior, i.e. me, Sawyer, and Paul. And we're going to try to keep the same aspect. We're going to grow a little bit, try and keep all the same stuff, like all of our equipment-wise. We got to find another person to pull trailer if if he's not there, he was the truck all summer. So we're gonna try and keep it the exact same and improve.
Yeah, I think like he said, our coach has always instilled community service with us. So it's a lot easier once the group's already formed for people to kind of jump in later and want to help out. I mean, like he said, I joined later and it was pretty easy to get into it, and I enjoyed doing it every day.
To keep following these guys and for more information or to donate to Free Lawn Care, visit their Facebook page. For High School Sports Weekly, I'm Susan Carruthers.